Welcome to a new How to BIM tutorial. In this video, we'll delve into the automatic approach of Revit 2024 to generate analytical models from physical structural models. This method differs from the manual process we used to do in earlier versions like 2022 Revit. I'm gonna also guide you through adding various types of loads to the structure and demonstrate how to set your boundary conditions to your structure, so we can create a model that's ready for a seamless integration with softwares like Robot Structural Analysis or any other analysis tool. So let's get started. Assuming you're using Revit 2022, the first thing to do, or we used to do, is duplicating your 3D view and then giving it a name related to your analytical model. Then double click V on your keyboard or go to your visibility graphic override and make sure that you show your analytical model category and hide the physical model category. But if you're using a version that's Revit 2023 or 2024, when you select structural element and go to the property tab, you won't find the show analytical model option under the structure category. Instead, this is the new way to do it. We're gonna go to analyze and we'll click on analytical automation. This is a very easy process. It'll save you a lot of time. You're either gonna go from an analytical to physical or from physical to analytical model. In our case, it's physical and analytical model. So the first step is setting your input, and we're gonna select our structural elements in Revit. I'm gonna use the filter, and I'm gonna filter out the levels and the structural rebar. Apply OK, and then you can check your elements and simply run the automation. It will only take seconds, and then you will get your analytical model. It kind of looks a little messy because I did not hide my physical model, so I'm gonna go to visibility graphic override and hide my physical elements. And there it is, my analytical model. If you guys are interested in creating the physical model, the reinforced concrete structure, starting with the concrete and then adding the reinforcement, you can check the video on the right top of the screen. For now, I think I'm gonna hide the analytical notes to make it look a bit cleaner. Yes, that looks better. Now we're gonna go to the next step, which is setting our boundary conditions, adding our boundary for our structure. And we're gonna go to insert, load family, and I'm gonna load my library family. It's a French library. I'm gonna go to conditions d'appui and I'm gonna load them. If you don't have a structural library, you can request one in the comments and I'll be happy to share mine with you. Next thing to do is going to analyze boundary conditions, and we're gonna click on the tiny arrow structural analytical model where we'll find the load combination and the boundary condition settings. Gonna go to boundary condition settings, and here we could set all our boundaries. Then we're gonna click again on boundary condition and choose point and place it at the end of each of our columns. If you guys are interested in real automation and real saving time while modeling, you could check the playlist linked in the right top of the screen. It will teach you how to create columns, beams, floors, and walls all without having to actually model them, and by using Dynamo, the visual coding tool in Revit. I will also link the playlist in the description below so you could guys check it out if you're interested. Let's try to change the display option. Enough playing with the display, and let's go to the loads. So Revit gives you the choice to either add point loads, line loads, area loads, or you could pick your host, or you could define the boundary. For example, the line loads, here you could change the forces, the value of your forces. And you could simply choose whichever line you wanna pick. The point load, for example, we could go to the columns, add it at the end of the column. There's also the area load. You could change the load cases. You technically have all the cases you could possibly need as a structural engineer. and you could place them. You can also decheck the uniform load option, as well as the projected loads. Now, if you wanna use the on-host option, it will pick the host that you selected. And concerning the area load, for example, you could simply pick the floor. Let's just change the value of the force in here so we could get a quite appealing example. And you simply pick the floor. If you want to work on a certain boundary, you could use the line tool or the pick line tool and choose the boundary of your load area. And as usual, you could change the value of the forces. You could also change the units by clicking UN. You technically get all the options that you could possibly need as a structural engineer who creates his models in Revit, who creates his physical models in Revit, and then needs to perform a structural analysis on this created model. There's also the robot structural analysis add-on that could link your model to robot, and if you do any modification, it will simply be updated. But overall, that's it. That's it for today's tutorial. If you've just started using Revit and you want to learn how to create models like these, following the best structures for modelers, you could watch the two videos in which I've created this model, one for creating the element and the second one is for creating reinforcement for these elements, as you can see in these sections. I will make sure to also link this playlist in the description as well. And yes, that's it for today's tutorial. I hope it was helpful. I hope that's your cue if you're still using a older Revit version. I hope that's your cue to update it to 2023 or 2024. Thank you for watching this video, and check out the rest of my playlists and videos if you're interested in Revit tutorials, Navisworks hand coordination tutorials, and automation with Dynamo. Thank you for watching.